The low-profile world just got a little more interesting with Scythe's release of the Big Shuriken 3 CPU cooler. Howdy howdy guys, Ponchato here, and today we'll be taking a look at the latest iteration of the Big Shuriken low-profile CPU coolers from Scythe. We'll also be comparing the stock fan, which is only 15mm tall, with a standard height 25mm fan, and see how big of a difference those 10mm make. Let's get to it. The Big Shuriken 3 was released just a few months ago in March of 2019 for around $45. It's compatible with AM4, LGA 1151, and LGA 2066, and though Scythe doesn't give it a TDP rating, I estimate it can handle around 150 watts with the stock fan and 130 watts with the 25mm fan. That does sound a bit counterintuitive, but I'll explain how that can be later in the video. The dimensions are where the Big Shuriken really shines. Looking at it from the top, it's about 120 millimeters square, but comes in at only 69 millimeters tall. That means it'll fit into the vast majority of slim or mini ITX cases. With a 25mm fan installed, it stacks up at 79mm tall, which is still compatible with a good majority of slim cases. Because of its offset heat pipe design, the Big Shuriken stays completely clear of the RAM slot, so there's no limit to RAM height. And because of its small stature, the Big Shuriken only weighs 475 grams. It comes with all the hardware you'll need: mounting brackets, thermal paste, screws and spacers, and the backplate for Intel motherboards. It also includes longer fan screws in case you'll be using a 25mm fan, which we'll also be testing in this video. The heatsink itself is comprised mostly of a tight aluminum fin stack. The fins are shorter at the edges to allow more clearance for tall VRM heatsinks or other motherboard components, and Scythe wrapped the edge in a black sheath which has threaded holes on the corners for mounting the fan. The included fan is Scythe's Kaze Flex 120 Slim. As the name implies, this is a 120 millimeter fan, only 15 millimeters in height, compared to the standard fan height of 25 millimeters. It's rated for 300 to 1800 RPM and spins on a fluid dynamic bearing, which gives it a mean time to failure of 100,000 hours. The fan also includes rubber corner grommets to help isolate vibration, though Scythe's fans have always been very well balanced to begin with, at least in my experience. We'll also be testing the Big Shuriken with Scythe's standard height Kaze Flex 120, which is 25 millimeters tall. This fan is rated for 300 to 1200 RPM, also uses a fluid dynamic bearing, but comes with a mean time to failure of 120,000 hours. Like the Slim, it includes rubber corner grommets for isolation. The 25mm fan goes for about 15 bucks, which brings the total to $60. The Big Shuriken uses basically the same mounting system as all of Scythe's current gen coolers, which is simple and effective. On AM4 systems, it uses the stock backplate, so the first step is to remove the AM4 mounting brackets on top. With those out of the way, you place the four plastic and rubber spacers over the backplate mounting holes. After that, the mounting arms get screwed down onto the spacers, and a dab of thermal paste goes onto the CPU to get it ready for the cooler. Remove the plastic cover on the base of the cooler, I point this out in every review because someone is bound to forget it, and then set the cooler down on the processor, lining up the screws attached to the cooler's crossbar with the threaded holes in the mounting arms. The thing I really, really like here is how the cooler actually gets tightened down. You don't need to remove the fan or deal with any insanely annoying clips. Scythe added space between the fins so you can easily reach the screws with a normal screwdriver. All you have to do is alternate tightening them down so the cooler stays level and evenly mounted. Once it's attached, plug in the PWM cable and it's ready to go. This mounting system is significantly easier to deal with than some other low-profile mounting systems I've used in the past. Scythe is consistently one of the best when it comes to installation, whether for low-profile coolers like this or huge mega towers. Honestly, Scythe reminds me a lot of Japanese car and motorcycle manufacturers. They keep it simple and just do what makes sense, and that makes the end user experience so much nicer. While we're on the topic of installation, to replace the stock fan, you simply undo the four corner screws, line up the new fan with the included 25mm fan screws, and tighten it back down. Very simple. Now let's get to the core and check out the benchmarks. First up, idle temperature with the fans at their minimum RPM, which is 300 RPM for both the stock fan and 25mm fan. At the same RPM, wider blades are going to move more air than thinner blades, so the thicker fan outperforms the stock fan by about 5 degrees. But both fall behind the very similar Shadowrock LP from Be Quiet. Now here are the idle noise levels. The 25mm fan is ever so slightly quieter at 29.8 decibels, with the stock fan just over that at 30.2. At these noise levels though, you'd be very hard pressed to hear them unless you're sitting in a completely silent room with your PC right next to your head. They are practically silent. Now we'll look at the load temperatures, with the fans at full speed. With the stock fan 3 degrees cooler than the 25mm fan, the difference in cooling performance is actually backwards from what I expected. But on further inspection, it makes sense. Because of the much higher max speed of 1800 RPM, the stock 15mm fan has a higher static pressure of 1.35 millimeters of H2O, compared to the 25mm fan that only pushes 1.05. Because of that, the stock Big Shuriken 3 beats the Be Quiet Shadowrock LP, its closest competition, by almost 3 degrees. Finally, load noise. The first thing you'll probably notice here is that the Big Shuriken stock fan can actually get pretty loud at 51.5 decibels. The 25mm fan is significantly quieter at only 42.7, actually one of the lowest noise coolers I've tested. But the change in noise level isn't the only difference. The sound from the 25mm Kaze Flex is also lower pitched due to its larger blades and slower 1200 RPM limit, which makes it even less noticeable under load. Now here's noise versus temperature to show the cooler's performance across its range of RPM. With this, you can compare cooler's noise levels at a given temperature or temperature at a given noise level. I think this shows the difference between the 15 and 25mm fans a bit better. While the 25mm fan has a smaller RPM range, which limits how low the delta can go, it does outperform both the stock fan and the Shadowrock LP across its entire range. So if you aren't as concerned with the absolute upper limit of cooling and want to go for a more balanced approach, the 25mm fan is a good upgrade. Now here's the chart of cooler scores, which compares coolers running at their optimal speed balanced between cooling performance and noise level. As expected, being a low profile cooler, the Big Shuriken 3 ranks near the bottom of the list when compared primarily with tower coolers and AIOs. But compared with the Shadowrock LP, the BS3 is almost identical. With the 25mm fan installed, it partially closes the gap to the larger coolers with a 39.2. Finally, cooler score per dollar to show price to performance. Due to its relatively high total cost of $60, the Big Shuriken with the 25mm fan scores near the bottom, but the stock Big Shuriken hits just below the similar Shadowrock LP. As always, low profile coolers don't look great by these metrics because smaller heat sinks simply can't cool as well as large towers. Overall, the Big Shuriken 3 is a great option for a low profile cooler. The question of whether or not you should spend a bit more and get the 25mm fan to replace the stock 15mm fan depends on your use case. Generally speaking, the stock fan has stronger cooling because it has a higher max RPM. However, the 25mm fan is significantly quieter under load. As long as your CPU is drawing under 130 watts, which is about as high as I'd go with the 25mm fan, I would go with the 25mm fan. I don't think the extra 3 degrees afforded by the stock fan are worth increasing the noise level by almost 10 decibels. But if the CPU you're using runs over 130 watts, or if you're working in an extremely slim case that doesn't have an extra 10 millimeters for the thicker fan, your only option is the stock fan. Silver lining though, it'll be cheaper. Outside of the 25mm comparison, the other cooler I'm comparing it to most closely is the Shadowrock LP from Be Quiet, which is very similar in terms of size, price, and performance. The biggest difference between them is the installation procedure. The Big Shuriken 3's is excellent, even by tower cooler standards, while the Shadowrock LP's is, I'm trying to find a way to put this diplomatically, but it is just really bad. So between the Big Shuriken 3 and Shadowrock LP, I would definitely recommend the Big Shuriken. Another big benefit of a cooler like this, which doesn't get mentioned enough, is the cooling it provides for the CPU VRM. VRMs can get really hot if they don't have a fan blowing directly on them, up to the point where the VRM, not the CPU itself, will start thermal throttling. I actually ran into this issue while testing another cooler recently. My CPU temperature was fine, but for some reason the voltage was dropping during extended thermal tests. After digging through the BIOS and double checking all my readings, I finally looked at the VRM temperature, which was bouncing off 125 degrees Celsius. That looked wrong, so being the scientist that I am, I touched the heatsink to check, and surprise of surprises, it was like touching a stove. I now trust my motherboard's temperature sensors. Anyway, because the Big Shuriken 3 hangs over the VRM, it provides a lot more direct airflow than any other type of cooler. That can make a big difference in temperatures and therefore stability at higher loads with more powerful processors. Follow the link in the description to get a Big Shuriken 3, and if you're opting for the 25mm fan, there's a link for that as well. Hit subscribe and click the bell icon to get notified of new videos as soon as they're up. If you like this video, hit the like button. If you want to see more, hit subscribe, and I want to hear from you. Would you go for the stock fan or the 25mm fan? Let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching. I hope I helped. And I'll see you in the next video. Now, before somebody calls me a baka in the comments, yes, I know it's pronounced shuriken, but like, everybody in the West says shuriken, and I don't want to look like a nerd, so I deliberately say it wrong too, for fear that I may be otherwise shoved into a locker or dropped into a trash can. The Big Shuriken uses basically the same mounting. Jesus Christ, that was loud.